to Military Pilates. I'm going to do a back session today and a bit of sciatic relief really. So anyone that suffers with sciatica pain and any pain sort of around the hip area, down the leg where there's possibly something pressing on the sciatic nerve, going to help to release off around that area. Just a bit of a disclaimer, I'm not a physio, so if you've got any, you know, continual numbness and tingling pains, then you obviously do need to go through the NHS physios and get them to check it. But some of these moves can definitely give a bit of light relief for a few hours. Okay, so first of all, we're going to warm up a little bit, so roll the shoulders up and down. As always, we need to warm up. So normally I would say to squeeze the glutes, but I just want you to relax your bottom through these sessions if you've got a lot of pain in the sciatica area, in your lumbar spine. Just relax your glutes today. Roll the shoulders forward. Okay, hold on to something if you need to, and just let the legs swing forward and back. You don't need to hold on to anything, just mobilize through the hips. And a bit of a hip opener. If you find that difficult on your supporting leg, again hold on to something, bend the knee, open. And open out. Big circles, and then the other way. Okay, and then swap sides. Open up. And then in. Make sure you stay hydrated through the moves. It's quite a chilled class today. I'd normally be teaching at the weekend, so I'm missing all my clients, so I hope this helps. Okay, so we're just going to roll down first of all. Inhale, exhale, peel down, peel the spine down. Okay, roll down as far as you can. If you're really tight, this will be difficult. Just go as far as you can. Inhale and exhale, peel up. And roll down. And roll up. And roll up. Halfway down, hands on the knees, stick the pelvis out and round under and release. We just want to warm up the lumbar spine. Any tension there, this will help. Just a little bit of that. Okay, bring the elbow in, look up, and exhale to the other side. Deep breaths in and out. Okay, right, we're going to get down onto the floor and start by doing supine and releasing the lumbar spine off. Okay. Okay. So you're going to tip the pelvis back and forward. So you're in that neutral spine, knees hip distance apart. You'll have seen this before in some of my classes or in some of the videos on YouTube. Chin forward. Again, so we're just relaxing the glutes. Just make sure you've got heavy in the hips, yeah? And just let it, just hold it there and just let, feel the sort of hips spread out a bit. Feel that connection with the floor. Take deep breaths in and out. Just making sure you take time to relax the glutes. Okay, right. We're going to do figure four now. So put the heel onto the opposite leg, just below the knee, okay? Then you're going to put your hands behind the thigh, yeah? And pull in, two, three, and release, two, three. Now what you want to do is make sure you're at a 90 degree angle, so it looks like a figure of four. So the foot is flexed, yeah? The sit bones are heavy, there's no tension in this area. You put your hands in and you pull. Now hold it there for about 30 seconds. That's going to release any tightness in this gluteal area down to the piriformis. Hold it for 10 seconds. Now just pull back and forward, so just slightly rock. Gives a bit of a deeper stretch. If you've got quite a lot of pain today, then you don't need to do this. Just hold it. It's going to help. Make sure your neck's comfortable. Release any tension you might have in your neck. Make sure you've got the nice alignment in the spine and the pelvic area. Okay, so that's what you can do. You rock back and forward. If you want an even deeper stretch, if you're not feeling too much pain today, you can slightly bring your head off, and this elbow, you push the elbow against the knee as you pull towards your body. So you're pushing and pulling. So that movement, the push-pull movement, creates that deeper stretch. And hold it there, head up. Deep breaths in and out. And the key is to enhance the stretch every time you breathe into the pain. So inhale and then exhale. You push as you breathe out. And pull the belly button down to the ground. You still relax in the glutes. Let's do that a couple more times. Inhale and exhale. Again, don't have your head up if your neck's sore. And release. This time, hold it for 10 seconds. Okay, and release. Well done. Take that foot off. Just give it some circles there. So you're in that tabletop 90 degree angle. Adjust your position, neck nice and comfortable, palms facing the floor. Make sure your hips are wide and you've got a neutral spine in the lumbar. Okay, so you're point and flex the foot. So this is great for anyone that's been doing a lot of HIIT exercises recently. So any sort of high intensity work you've been doing, you need to stretch off, whether it be the same day or the next day, or you're just going to keep getting compression in that area, which will only exacerbate any symptoms of sciatica. You don't want to end up with piriformis syndrome. Okay, so now you're going to straighten that leg. Okay, so it's perpendicular. Put your hands behind the thigh, behind the hamstring. And pull in and release. In and release. Don't worry if you can't straighten your leg like me. I've obviously been doing this a while. You can have it in a bent. You position shoulders down. So pull it in. And then try to straighten as much as you can. So I can obviously straighten my leg. But some people who are particularly tight in this area and have sciatic problems are not going to be able to get very far with this. Don't worry. Okay, you just want to try and, your aim is to try and bring that heel to the ceiling. So you're stretching out in this area. Don't forget to exhale on the effort and pulse. Okay, deep breaths in. And exhale. hold it for 30 seconds. Keep this bottom heavy on the ground. Hold if you don't want to bend and straighten. Good. Circles. Well done. Now we swap sides. Okay, so we're going to do the same sciatic stretch on the other side. Cross the foot over into the figure four. Okay. Again, if it's really sore, just, if you're having a bad day and you don't want to do this, just hold it there and then you can push your hand onto the thigh slightly, just there in that area. So you push, even that's going to help, it opens up the hips. Okay, that's a start. Okay, if you're ready to do the next one, figure four, hands behind. Forward, relax. Deep breaths in and out. Keep that tailbone heavy. Don't hold the glutes. Relax. Okay, we're going to step it up now. So, this is the one where you come up slightly with your head and the elbow pushes against the thigh. Okay. A deeper opening into that gluteal area to release any tension, any impingement. Deep breaths in and out. Try to make sure your pelvis is aligned. That wasn't great there, okay? If your neck's sore, don't bring your neck up. Keep it down. You can still do it. You know your own body, guys, okay? Just take it at your own pace. Remember, Pilates is about progression and building it up over time. I have good days and bad days. Some days I couldn't do half the moves. But the next day I can manage them, so just depends how you're feeling. Down to the ground and pull it in. Oh, other leg. Okay, bend and straighten. And straighten. Now you might find you've got one leg that's tighter than the other. That's normal. Your dominant leg might be tighter. Or you might have referred to pain than the other leg if you've been overusing one leg. Yeah. Let's create that movement again. Don't worry if you can't come too high. Your aim is to try and pull it up and down. Good, nice and slow. Okay, hold it for 30 now. more. So as you can see, I'm just alternating, I'm just playing with it really. Just moving in and out with the stretch, nice and gently. Okay, good, hug the knees in. Circle the toes. Bring your knees in, give them a hug, and then release them out. Inhale, exhale, open. Inhale, exhale, open. And then the other way. Flex your feet if you need to. So that was a basic sciatica stretch there, right. Let's go on to do clam. So lying on your side, knees together, feet together. Do what you want with your neck. You can have it supported in your hand, or you can lie down if you're feeling a bit tired. Just make sure your neck is comfortable, okay? So the knees are together, feet together. You're just going to open and close. Now again, if you've got pain and you're doing this class because you've got lower back pain or you've got sciatica pain, don't squeeze your glutes, just relax them today. If you feel like you can, strengthen up, because strengthening is good for this area too and will help prevent sciatica pain in the future. It's having the right balance between strengthening and stretching. So this can be both. It can be a relaxed move or it can be a strengthened move. It depends how much effort you want to put in. So just slowly open and slowly close, just to tease it open a bit, like a clamshell. Dead easy. Five more. Okay, just straighten that leg out. Flex the foot. Bend it in. And release. Push, 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 push. Just slowly and gently. Fill your abdominals in. So work on the abs here rather than the glutes. Two more. And release. Good. Okay. Right. I'm going to go to the other side now. Keeping it dead easy and dead basic for everyone. So, again, position. Knees together, feet together. Open. Two, three. Close. Two, three. Again, just relax. Glutes. Should feel quite nice in the hip area. So these exercises combined with some of my more intensive Pilates classes, because some of the classes I do can be quite a good cardio workout, to be fair, if you do some of the fitness classes I do, fitness Pilates classes I do. And then combine it with a couple of these a week as well, you'll get that all over routine where you've got the strengthening and stretching and lengthening any tight areas. I will be doing a fascia class soon, which is where we use the prickle balls. So watch out for that one coming soon. That's going to get really deep into the integral tightness, into those deep tissue muscles, like a deep tissue massage, really. Okay, two more. Okay, slowly bend that knee in. Two, three, and push out. Two, three. Notice I'm not coming too high. It's almost in line with my hips, really. You don't want to be much higher. Two more. Good. And release. Roll into your front, into prone. Curl your toes under. Yeah. Again. Just release the glutes. Normally we have them all fired up and we're really squeezing and strong, so it needs to relax, let it all go floppy. There, push, curl your toes right under and push the heels back. And just take deep breath in. And then, so we're going to come up into cobra, so slightly push up. So we're strengthening the lower back, we're extending out through the chest. This helps because it's all connected around the sciatica area. So a lot of people, if you've been slouching or your posture's not good, you are going to be more at risk as well of sciatica over time. So the important thing is to do a bit of back strengthening and releasing of the back area as well. And push up, hold it there. And a smile. Well done, everyone. This has gone really well. Shoulder back. Watch out for the back exercise coming soon. I'll be doing a back strengthening one. Get a nice strong back, hold it there. Right, push up onto all fours. Hold it in that position. So on floors, now come back into shell stretch. Reach out. Come up and back. So you're coming back and forward. Mobilizing the hips. Bring up into a straight back. This is the back that we talk about in class, the strong back that balances all your beers, your proseccos. Don't let them fall. Okay. Okay, turn the toes under. Push back through the heels. Then forward. Hold that waist in. You're still really relaxing the glutes for me, guys. Round up into cat and release. Just your position if you need to. Okay, right now we're going to do another good one for the sciatica. Yeah, so we're going to do pigeon or a modification of pigeon. So you bring your leg forward into a right angle. Hopefully you can see me in the mirror. Yeah? Now this can be quite difficult for some people. If you can't get your other leg behind you and sit up, then you can have a modified pigeon position where you bend it round like that, okay? So, bring the foot up, you're gonna reach over and push in to the glute area, so your bone, yeah? So you lean forward on your hands, chest comes down, and most people know pigeon because it's a yoga move, basically. So you can do variations where you roll from side to side. Or you can push up and down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. You can only sit down, that's fine. Even if you can't come that far and you're just in a modified, anything is fine, it's going to stretch it out, okay? Keep pressing. Alright. Okay, swap sides. I'm going to move the mat around so you can see. From the front might be easier. Okay, so lean forward, foot round. I mean, some people are really flexible and can get this right into a 90 degree angle. So inhale up, exhale down, push, and up. And again, if you can, go bend your knee, yeah, and reach as far as you can. Push, two, three. So that is quite an intense sciatica stretch. Okay, you can do move sitting up as well on a seat. I'll show you the seated one in a minute. So if you struggle to get down to the ground, not a problem, you can do it in a seated position as well. Okay, good. Right. Feet together, inhale. Exhale, roll forward. Okay, so as well, if you, like I said, if you're struggling to get down to the floor to do your sciatic stretch, if your pain's that bad, you can do it on a seat. So feet flat on the seat, sitting up straight. Inhale and exhale, roll down. As far as you can, it's comfortable to loosen off the lower back and slowly come up. Make sure your sit bones are nice and heavy, your glutes are spread, okay? Keep going. Only go as far as you can that's comfortable, guys. Make sure the chair is nice and supported and comfortable. You can have a nice flat Pilates cushion on it or a towel. This is going to loosen off the lumbar spine area. Bring your toes up and down. Okay. Come to the edge of the seat. So what you want is to be, again, at right angle, shoulders back, sit up nice and straight. Okay. Don't slouch, please. There's no point in that. Shoulders back. It's all about posture. You're going to cross the leg over. Foot on top of the knee. Out, okay, and then you're going to push with your hands you hold onto the other side of the chair and use the chair to help your posture to keep your shoulders back. So you push down slightly. That is a really good, amazing stretch actually for any tightness in that area, guys. I really recommend you do some of these every day if you're prone to pain there. 5 minutes, that's all. You don't have to do the full video. You could do half of it in the morning, half of it at night, or whatever. But one thing's for sure, if you don't do it, it's not going to help. Just loosen off the neck, guys. Relax the shoulder. The other leg over. Push your position. Push down. And hold for 30 seconds. Holding the sciatica stretch for about 30 seconds is going to help to release it out a bit, open it up. We'll be doing a whole series of chair-based exercises coming soon, so watch this space. And release. Good. Okay, I'll do one more for the chair. Put the chair in front, the foot on, one hand on the chair. Reach down, nice hamstring stretch, aim to reach for the toe, straight back. Okay, hold on to the chair if you need to. And hold the stretch, this gets really deep into the hams, guys. Hamstring stretch. Okay, swap legs. Reach for the toe if you can. Wherever you can go is fine. Hold the waist in, straight back. Watch the chair doesn't fall from you, and watch your supporting leg. That's a really intense stretch. I love this one. I quite often do chair-based Pilates classes because I do have quite an elderly population in my classes, so we often use the chairs, and it's good fun. It's a really good variation of Pilates, I love it. And using equipment helps to give you a deeper stretch as well. Okay, well done. Right, last stretch. Turn the chair around. Make sure it's supported. Walk the feet back. Stick the back out. Push the chair, stick the tailbone out. Sit, hold the waist in, nice flat back. And reach. 2, 3. Round the upper back and reach. 2, 3. Last one. Right, curl the tailbone under. Slow, peel up. Stacking the tailbone up right up through the cervical spine. Relax the shoulders, round the shoulders off. Good, okay. So that's it, guys, well done. So you should feel a nice and looser in all this area around here. Yeah. So again, if you're into doing high intensity workouts at the minute, running, weights, whatever, please do these sort of stretches. And just take it easy if you've been in a lot of pain. If the pain doesn't get any better, go see the GP. But yeah, this will definitely help. I'm also going to be doing a foam roller class coming soon. So these are really good for sciatica. Yes, very good. So we'll be doing a more intense class of foam roller and fascia release coming soon. So watch the space. Also, if you can get hold of these, great. They are quite expensive, but they're about £40. But you can get the smaller foam rollers, are just as good. They're about £12-15. But this one's good for the whole body. So yeah. All right, guys, thank you, have a great day. Don't forget to check out my YouTube channel and like, share and click the subscribe button, which should be just about there on your screen. Please click it and let people know about this, please. The more people tune in, the more classes I'll be able to do. Okay, cool. Have a great day. Bye.